Where did they go? Nowhere!
Cheesy Gubbins.
The only thing you can count on.
Are responsible for, well, for a lot actually. Janitor needed to unblock toilets. Lovely.
You're listening to Campus Radio. I'm DJ Shorts, bringing you small batch homegrown radio with the pulp left in. Here's a musical palate cleanser that's sure to wash that pre-digested rubbish out of your ears. See if you can taste the difference.
place. Thank you. Just got bigger, not necessarily better. Should try to be less terrible. Students should report all issues to someone that cares.
I want to talk about an actor by the name of Roderick Cushion. Now, if you listen to popular thinking, you'd think, now there's a guy who's given up on his craft. There's an actor that would literally do anything for the next paycheck. And sure, I can see how you could think that. But you'd be completely missing the point. When Roderick Cushion decides to do yet another truly terrible film, he's making a statement about the nature of commercial cinema. Thank you, Mr. Cushion, for fighting the good fight.
Your finger is not a toothbrush.
Hmm.
We've got a music review for you now. Over to Muggy, who's been to see the Boogie Nights.
That's right, I went to the Boogie Nights concert and it was great. The lights, the dancing and so on. If you like music, this really was music. I do think the campus could do with some better signage though. I mean, I almost missed the concert and this segment could have been a real train wreck if that had happened.
At Jumbo, we know it's our employees that are the big deal. That's why they get the Jumbo treatment. Mobile stationery, toilet substitute, sip of milk, leg rooms, dental surgeries, additional headrest, and our famous data system analysis training program system, or FIDAPSTAPS. I'm Jumbo McNally, and I wish I worked here.
Cheesemongering. timetable has now been published. Schedule your lives accordingly. Janitor needed to unblock toilets. Lovely.
Nah, I think the Orb Foundation gets far too much criticism. Sure, there's some dodgy information about how they're funded, and they do talk a lot about the Orb being the perfect shape. I can't be the only one sick of those adverts. But really, what are they, if not a group of people coming together to appreciate some beauty in this world? Personally, I think we could all learn a little something from them.
Yes, we are testing you. Campus is not responsible for meteors or any other celestial shrapnel. Thank you. Intruders, please not come in. issues should go to student support. Expanding even more than usual. Janitor required in bathroom. Students are reminded that you came here on purpose. Frequently asked questions. I believe that smell is you.
Sir Nigel Bickleworth on Two Point Radio. I hear that another university has opened its doors to the aspiring bookworms and lab rats of Two Point County. Listeners may remember that I don't like new universities because they're not old and therefore not any good. If they were, they'd have opened a long time ago. That's called logic, students, though I don't suppose you'd know.
library. Students with pastoral issues should go to student support. Are reminded to bounce back from heart-wrenching disappointment. Weather report. It's raining space rocks.
Welcome back. I can't say that I understand our county's recent fascination with opening pop-up universities on a weekly basis, but it seems appropriate to commemorate the opening of yet another fun-time house of real good learning. I thought we'd talk about the past, memories, and nostalgia. The feelings that things used to be in some incalculable and all-encompassing sense better. But why do we feel that way? Are we wearing rose-tinted glasses? Perhaps. Did everything used to be better? Probably.
The campus has opened a new building. Good for us. Requesting assistant.
Thank you.
bathroom.
I love taking the train, the steam, the crisp sandwiches, watching people's luggage fall. Oh, those were the days. Sadly, I now find the experience of using our county's rail services is missing one rather vital component. I find that everyone seems all too engrossed by their mobile phones. Now, I have no interest in talking to anyone, but what I did like was ignoring people. It's just no fun if they do it for you.
Students are reminded to have the time of their lives. Students with medical issues should go to the health clinic.
Get some gubbiny grub in your gob with cheesy gubbins. The essence of cheese.
Cheesy gubbins.
Cheesy gubbins. You know you want to.
Janitor to collect litter. Sorry. Please put your pencils down. Only kidding. Responsible for meteors or any other celestial shrapnel. Thank you. Janitor needed to unblock toilets. Lovely.
Was recently stolen back to the days of my youth. Yes, after inadvertently trapping myself in the airing cupboard, what did I come across but my old wooden tennis clogs? It had been too long since I thought about my days on the university tennis team. It was said that the mere sound of our carved shoes were enough to cause eruptions of rosy cheeks and giggling on campus. Although some believed that it had something to do with our shorts.
Attention, your finger is not a toothbrush. The campus is not responsible for anything that happens in the science lab. students are reminded that you're letting everyone down.
Whatever happened to wooden tennis shoes anyway? The visual spectacle of tennis used to be accompanied by a positive symphony, a sound like a company of coconuts dancing on a ballroom floor. Only wooden tennis clogs can produce such an enchanting auditory experience. But what do they wear now? Ghastly squeaky things. And for what? Added grip? Light weight? It's practically cheating.
Starting soon. Was there anything we wanted to do?
The rise of the synthetic shoe is not confined to the tennis court, sadly. I'm sure many long-time listeners know that I visit Confetto's Cobblers once a year and treat myself to a pair of brogues or loafers if I'm feeling scandalous. On my most recent visit, however, I was horrified to find that my dear cobbler had been replaced with an establishment by the name of the Shoe Zoo. But can one truly describe their collection of footwear as a menagerie without possessing a single pair of brogues? I think not.
Janitor required in bathroom.
Remember the start of the show? Remember when we were going to talk about nostalgia? Oh, what a paradise it seems. And yet, here we stand, talking about training shoes. Another vision gone awry over the savage passing of time. How fitting. How dreadfully sad. Things used to be better, dear listeners. How can you know for sure? Well, my show is over. They can't be getting better, can they?
Is starting. I hope you have a pencil. frequently asked questions. I believe that smell is you. Students are reminded to be in two places at once. Weather report. It's raining space rocks. Students might want to try something else. Attention. Your finger is not a toothbrush. Janitor to install upgrade, please. We'll be right back.
whether you're just getting up or just getting in, it's sure to be difficult. I'm Felicity Bellbottoms, and you're listening to Campus Radio, where we try and make whatever you're doing a little bit easier and a little bit noisier.
Showering is technically, but not socially, optional.
Student protests continued to rage in the music college at Mitten today. Asked for their thoughts, feelings, or demands, one student had this to say. I don't know, really. Someone told me we're waiting to see an enormous bassoon. Is that not right? More on that curious bassoon later in the show.
Students should try to be less terrible. Thank you. is technically but not socially optional.
It's time for a review of the most popular cartoon on campus. Yes, that's right, the Bureaucrats. This week, I'm reviewing the Bureaucrats. Yesterday, Mittens, the cat, found an outrageously obscure bylaw just in time to delay a civil case another 10 weeks. Now, I don't understand the justice system at all, but I do understand drama, and those cats have it. Five cat paws out of a possible five.
There's a fly in here. The campus is not responsible for meteors or any other celestial shrapnel. Thank you. Questions. I believe that smell is you.
Beaver from Bungle. The small car that makes the little things feel bigger than they are. It's a perspective thing.
Plagiarism is not a belief system. Thank you. responsible for meteors or any other celestial shrapnel. Thank you. Showering is technically, but not socially, optional. Assistant to the library. Thank you.
Remarkably, we actually have a follow-up on the story of the enormous bassoon. It seems as though the crowd have got their hands on an inflatable and, indeed, enormous bassoon. I'm a little lost for words, if I'm perfectly honest with you listeners. Was this planned all along, or was it sourced after our segment aired? Just so many questions. They'll have to wait, I suppose. Until next time, I've been Felicity Bellbottoms, speechless on Campus Radio. Should go to the health clinic. Thank you.
is technically but not socially optional. Students in need of teaching.
Good morning. You're listening to Ricky Hawthorne on 2 Point Radio. Hello there, it's Ricky Hawthorne on 2 Point Radio, where today we'll be asking the question, do slow news days prompt needless questions? You won't be able to miss it.
Staff are reminded that they're easily replaceable. should work smarter and harder.
Later in the week, I'll be talking to the Boogie Knights. Those metal-clad funk makers are equal parts gallantry and groovy, groovy groove music. Knights and chivalry were first popular hundreds of years ago, of course. But isn't it funny how these trends come around? Stay courtly, kids.
Recently spent a weekend away on Pebbly Island, a beautiful locale in our proverbial neck of the metaphoric woods, where I stayed in a luxury hotel. Oh, I know what you're thinking. Oh, Ricky, you've changed. It's true. I do it all the time. I hardly recognize myself. Next up, mirrors. What are they looking at?
Join me in welcoming the mysterious space rock to campus.
of Quem Charlie has been overthrown by the evil green cruiser. From the Bay of Gravy to the Giblet Caves, this once succulent land has been turned a putrid green. There is only one who can save us now. Meet Wizard!
Explore a world of legend and lamb chops in Meet Wizard, Return of the Salami Sorcerer. Only on the Bungle Button Master, where the games be happening.
The academic year is over. Students must vacate the campus. Starting soon. Was there anything we wanted to do?
And now, the news and today's top story. Sensitive government documents first thought recovered are now feared to be deli meats. Now that is a shame, but at least there's a salty silver lining. What's a little cyber insecurity when you've got a face full of ham? Nice one.
The timetable is not written in stone. Still, we're not changing it. Announcement. Intruders on campus. Oh no.
Thank you.
Thank you. Students are reminded to apologize to the janitorial staff. I'm sure you've done something. Please join me in welcoming the mysterious space rock to campus.
Wasn't that a smashing tune? I'd have been tapping my toe from hither to yon if I wasn't completely tone deaf. Did you know that I'm also situationally tone deaf? Yes, I just cannot read a situation. I have one speed, and that's Ricky. There's another craze sweeping our county's youth. The so-called cheesy gob-off asks challengers to see how many cheesy gubbins they can stuff into their unsuspecting gobs. Competition is a wonderful thing, don't you think? It brings us all together and fills our mouths with cheese.
Assistant needed in library. Required in bathroom. Tuition fees are expensive, and education is priceless. Please join me in welcoming the mysterious space rock to campus. Needed to collect litter.
We are nearing the finish line today, but first, our producers wouldn't let me leave without trying my hand at the cheesy gob-off. Play that music while I gob on down.
I've done 60. You get my stray. I've been Ricky Hawthorne. See you around. That's quite nice. That's short. It's like cheesy.
Janitor required in training room. Are reminded to try and keep up. Required in bathroom. Students with pastoral issues should go to student support. Announcement. Plants need water, remember? The campus is not responsible for meteors or any other celestial shrapnel. Thank you. Students with medical issues should go to the health clinic. To clean up the place. Thank you.
Sir Nigel Bickleworth on 2 Point Radio. Welcome to 2 Point Radio, where it's a great day. Why? Because I, Sir Nigel Bickleworth, am talking into a microphone. Can you feel it? Can you hear me? Is this thing on? Really, Dennis, if this is off again, I'm going to come in there and dunk you like a biscuit. We'll check that I'm on the air and be back with more sumptuous sound wave salaciousness after this.
Janitor to maintain social simulator. questions will make you look stupid. Intruders on campus. You know what to do.
Why is it that the youth of today believe they can churn out a radio show from the comfort of their toilet seats? The gall! In my day, one had to work for years making sandwiches and polishing the communication tower before they even let you touch a microphone. There's more to radio than ability, charm, and technological literacy. Eager little autodidacts, the lot of them.
Janitor required in bathroom. Security breach. Please change your passwords. Sorry. space rock to campus.
My darling, albeit slack-jawed, nephew Kevin ushered me through cyberspace and into the world of video games. Yes, I played the latest entry in the popular Meat Wizard franchise for Sir Nigel Reviews. I was lost, I was cold, I was scared. The controller was sticky and the subject matter obscene. While I'm unsurprised that it appeals to the desensitized youth of today, I'll tell you what I told that chap in the deli. No one needs that much ham. One magical gem out of a possible five.
Starting soon. Was there anything we wanted to do?
New to the Crumley student range. Fish in a box. We at Crumley have been serving fish to Two Point County for over 10 years. It's a proud tradition, and now it's a tradition in a box. Easy to cook.
Wow!
Tasty to eat.
Wow!
You're not sure what it is, but it's definitely in a box. Just like Mama used to make. Thank you.
distracting. Even more than usual. Accordingly.
To the news and the controversies surrounding Education Minister Tarquin Foxbridge, who allegedly blew his nose on official government documents. Stories like this are scandalous. It's perfectly clear to me that a group of students have fabricated the images somehow, and yet this poor minister faces all manner of backlash and public murmurings. And why? Because he was photographed doing something? I know a witch hunt when I see one.
Janitor needed in dormitory. To the library. Thank you.
Down.
students are reminded to be constantly upbeat. Weather report. It's raining space rocks. Students with medical issues should go to the health clinic.
To be a one-way affair, this relationship of ours, and that's how it should be. What do you know about radio after all? Almost nothing, I'd imagine. Still, it's time for that rare occasion where we put you, the listener, at the center of things. I am the aunt to ease your agony, the balm to abate what bites you, the A to all your cues. I am listening. Oh, and we're out of time. We'll get to your problems after this, all right? All right.
Requesting assistant. Showering is technically but not socially optional. Thank you.
It's time for Agony Answers with me, Sir Nigel Bickleworth. This week's problem is from student Felony Bog Dropper, who writes, I've got loads of work but can't concentrate with all the noise in my flat. Well, Felony, I advise that you try a change of scenery. Work in the study. Write in the billiard room. Mill about in the converted mill. Why, read in the scullery. Your home is your castle. Utilize all of its many, many nooks and crannies. That's what got me through the hard times.
Your body's a temple, and you wouldn't fill a temple with crisps. If it's not on your CV, it didn't happen. Not to me. Provides healthcare for its students. Well, it should.
Like what you hear? Of course you do. So why not call in and let our producers know? Recent research suggests that over 97% of our listeners are incidental. That is, hearing by accident rather than intent. Collateral johnnies, if you will. Nevertheless, I have faith that each radio segment, like a juicy needle in a haystack of filth, is found by someone somewhere. Well done to you, today's deliberate listener.
Students should go to pastoral support for, well, anything really. Is a temple, and you wouldn't fill a temple with crisps. Requesting assistant. Students are reminded that some grades are personal. Weather report. It's raining space rocks. Assistant to the library. Thank you.
This is Campus Radio, and I'm your host, Felicity Bellbottoms. Speculation continues to build over that smell in the lecture theatre. But what should you believe? Did someone really stuff a block of cheddar under one of the seats? Or is it haunted? The answer may surprise you. Thank you.
decided to care about students. Needed to install upgrade. Thank you.
It's time for a book review. Over to Maggie, who's been reading the memoirs of 2 Point Radio's longest tenured DJ. This week, I've been reading A Life on the Waves by Ricky Hawthorne. Oh, so good. Really, really good. Because I didn't know before, actually, that he spent so much time at sea. Or, well, near any water, really, and that's just super interesting. A library might sound like a good thing, but here's Hugh to tell us why it's actually quite sad.
Here in Smogley, students have been looking forward to the renovation of the old campus library. The carpet is plush and the study areas are dressed with kettles and beanbags. The library is alive and bustling, but the old bookcases are left on the outside looking in. Yes, 3 old bookcases stand on the lawn outside the library, a monument to a past that's now over. Spare a thought for them as you enjoy a sleek, frictionless library experience.
Assistant to the library. Thank you. Announcement. Intruders on campus. Oh no. Students with pastoral issues should go to student support. Some students have a long way to travel. Is that their problem or ours?
New to the Crumley student range. Fish in a box. We at Crumley have been serving fish to Two Point County for over 10 years. It's a proud tradition, and now it's a tradition in a box. Easy to cook.
Wow.
Tasty to eat.
Wow.
You're not sure what it is, but it's definitely in a box. Just like Mama used to make.
Are reminded to make us proud, or else. Needed to collect litter.
And there we have it. It's being reported that that smell in the lecture theatre was indeed a large piece of cheese. We're hearing that a member of the janitorial staff was seen retrieving the putrid wedge in a hazmat suit, though this particular source has been known to exaggerate. We can only hope the smell dissipates and our community can breathe deeply and cheeselessly once again.
report can be found in student support. Congratulations. Research project complete. Janitor is needed to collect litter.